A million.
You look like a million. Like a million.
Wonder-working Father, glory be to your name. Thank you for accepting our worship in Jesus' precious name. Let's give the Lord a round of applause. Amen. I believe that we are in for a blessing tonight in Jesus' name. And I think... Well, those that are at the back, maybe we move forward, because when those people that will come late from their jobs, say that please just be promoted, accept the promotion. You're upgraded. Move forward. You are saying amen in your seat, you're not moving forward. Move forward, please. At least those back, the last four rows at the back, leave them empty for those that will come from their job at 8:30 or 9. You are all upgraded in Jesus' name. Move to first class. Amen. Well, it is time to hear the word, and we thank God for the vessel, wonderful vessel prepared by the Lord for this occasion. This program is gathering momentum, and I'm sure that very soon, when we mention a taste of heaven, it will become a household program that people look forward to every year. And I believe that, you see, somebody said that there's no good business that starts from the top, only grave diggers. Every good business starts from the bottom and climbs up. So our programs as well, we are climbing up gradually in Jesus' name. Let's welcome to the podium today the man of God, Pastor Daniel Adeniyi. Pastor Adeniyi Daniel, I always tell them that, he is the general overseer of Hallelujah Christian Chapel, Abeokuta, Nigeria. I have heard about him, and he's been recommended by many people as a wonderful man of God. And this is our first time of having him in the house with us to minister to us. Sir, you are very much welcome in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I want to say good evening to everybody in Jesus' name. I'm a singing pastor, so I like to sing. You guys get on the phone. And I'll just sing a song of thanksgiving to God. And let's be grateful to our God together. Oh Lord, I have nothing to give you. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for mercy and grace. Oh Lord, I have nothing to give you. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for loving kindness. Wait. Oh Lord, I have nothing to give you. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for mercy and grace. Oh Lord, I have nothing to give you. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for loving kindness. Oh Lord, I have nothing to give you. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for mercy and grace. Oh Lord, I have nothing to give you. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for loving kind. Hallelujah. Oh Lord, I have nothing to give you. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for mercy and grace. Oh Lord, I have nothing to give. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for loving kind. Our Father, oh Lord, nothing to give you. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for mercy and grace. Oh Lord, I have nothing to give you. I just want to say thank you for love. Hallelujah.
Oh Lord, I have nothing to give you.
I just want to say thank you. Thank you for mercy and grace. Oh Lord, I have nothing to give you. I just want to say thank you for love. One more time. Hallelujah.
Oh Lord, I have nothing to give you.
I just want to say thank you. Thank you for mercy and grace. Yeah.
Oh Lord, I have nothing to give you. Thank you for loving kindness.
Holy and righteous Father, we bless your name. Thank you for your faithfulness over us. Thank you for your jealousy over us. Thank you for delighting in us. Thank you for making us to be accepted in the beloved. Thank you for making us to be partakers of the covenant of promise. Thank you for making us to be members of the Commonwealth of Israel. Accept our thanks, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we are gathered in your name. We are gathered in your house. We ask you to gather us further still beneath your breath and breathe deeply into our spirits from the living oracles of your word. Let your word distill like the dew of heaven, like the showers from heaven into our lives. And God, grant us an entrance, a gracious entrance to the living word of God, the living word of your grace. Let your word run a free course among us and cause it to be mightily glorified. Thank you, righteous Father. In Jesus' worthy name we pray it. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's please be seated. One more time, good evening, everybody. My brethren, thank you. And I want to thank our dearly beloved pastor and his wonderful, gracious wife for the opportunity they have given me, first of all, to be part of this Taste of Heaven meeting, and secondly, to be allowed to share in the meeting. We are all trusting God together that God will do us good in maximal ways in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, am I in the right place? God will do us good in maximal ways in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Let's start our story. So very strangely and very wonderfully too, our theme and topic is the narrow way. It's a matter for us to dilate upon, and I'm begging God and pleading with God that he will help us marvelously in the name of Jesus. Matthew, can you give me on the screen, multimedia, Matthew chapter 7, let's start from verse 14. Matthew chapter 7, maybe 13 and 14, please, quickly. It says, enter ye at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. And the sad part of it, suddenly, very strangely today, I became sad. When I looked at this scripture, I was very sad. It's just a feeling that dawned on me. I've read it several times, but in a very strange way. And many there be would go in their heart. 14 now, please. Because straight is the gate. And narrow is the way which led to life, leaded unto life. Another factor that made me very sad again is, and few there be that find it. The wrong way, many be that find it. The right way, few there be that find it. Now look at this. If you're into statistics, or if you're a little good in maths, if there's a number 10 and they say many, 4 out of 10, is it many? How about 5? Not really. How about six? We are starting. Not too many, actually. Seven? Maybe. Eight? Yes. Nine? Yes. Now, if they say few, it's nine few. How about six? Not really. And four? Maybe. Three? Yeah, maybe from there. And two? And one? You know what made me sad? This is what will happen at the end of age. God, Bible said, known unto God are all his works from the foundation of the world. So if we put 10 down, every time when we put 10 down, we are thinking of 1, 2, 3, maximum of 4, that we find the way. And God is never self-deceived. Never. Never has been, never will be. Never can be, actually. God have told himself, this way I am setting forth before my people, before my creatures. I know, well ahead of time, that few will find it. And like we said, that few may be speaking about 1, 2, 3, perhaps maximum of 4. So when you see people not wanting to do what God says or wanting to rationalize about it, wanting to be very empirical, very deep-thoughted, broadening the way and the horizon and perspective, perhaps orientation, they are just sliding into the many that will not find it. When you see anything in this world system that many people like, it is usually the wrong thing. When men start rationalizing on what God says, that's why this issue of effective parenting, if we don't, mommies and daddies, if we don't catch our children very, very young for God, it will take God himself, if ever it will happen, to catch them later in life. So as I read, you know, yesterday I told you, maybe some of us were not here, I said, the narrow way is like men, if you understand, I don't have to put it in your own language here, but let me put it in our Nigerian language or African language. I like men who wanted to write the high school exam, secondary school exam, called WAEC, the South African Examination Council examination. And they have written, the council has marked it, and the result has been released. So when you say, what's your result? And she says, I've passed. Passed enough to go to a higher university or a college. Then we are talking. And I said, many people that you people normally want to follow, they are just writing God's exam. Maybe God have marked, we are not even sure. Or God is waiting till they finish the exam. Then God will mark. So one, they are still writing the exam because until they drop dead, the exam has not finished. Two, God has not marked the exam. Three, the result has not been released. So I prefer to follow and listen to somebody who has written God's exam. God has marked the exam. God has released the exam result for us in scriptures. So if they say, this is the way to follow God, I will listen to such a fellow. But another fellow, you are still writing the exam. You are not even sure what you will score. And we don't know what will be your eventual result. I'll be foolhardy. I can't even follow my mind. When was I born? And in any case, there are people who have lived like me. if you want to check how God marked their exams and what result they got, so the matter of following God through the narrow path is a personal decision. And hear me, I plead with you by the mercies of God. God already has predicted. God already has told himself, few will find it. Few. Thank you, guys. To disturb my moment. Few will find it. Few. So if you're in a school and you're a group of 10 friends, permit me to tell you, few of you will find it, go for it, stay in the track, and get to heaven. Few. Few. Pastor was saying to us yesterday, if God changes the marking scheme, he has to apologize to Sodom and Gomorrah. God has to apologize. Whatever was called fornication in the Old Testament is also called fornication in the New Testament. Whatever is called a lie in the Old Testament is called a lie in the New Testament. Whatever is called deceit in the Old Testament is called deceit in the New Testament. God does not change the goalpost. Whatever is called unfaithfulness in the Old Testament, it's called unfaithfulness in the New Testament. And you know, one day, I saw the consistency of God. Please give me Matthew chapter 1. Give me from, maybe verse 4. Matthew chapter 1, verse 4. Very quickly, please. Come and see God. No, let me start. Give me from verse 1. I want to get somewhere. And come and see God's serious. Now, the book of the generation of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Verse 2, just follow as we are reading. Abraham gave birth to Isaac, Isaac gave birth to Jacob, Jacob gave birth to Judas and his brethren. 3, just on like that. And 4, verse 4, very quickly, just follow me, sir. And verse 5, and verse 6. Can we read verse 6 together, everybody? One, two, go. Who was that? It happened in the Old Testament. And as far as God was concerned, even in the New Testament, God did not change it. Uriah remains the wife of, Bathsheba remains the wife of Uriah forever. David, you slaughtered the man, collected the woman, but no trouble. This woman is a concubine in your house. She remains, for divine heavenly record, the wife of the man you killed. So, are we ready? When you marry her, if you like, move on with your life. That's the language. And marry 3, 4, 5 people in your lifetime. As far as God is concerned, this is your only wife. Other ones are concubines. Hey, but the guy was impossible, was frustrating, wanted to kill me. Move on to another life. What if, let's go to heaven. Let's ask God to carry us now and go to heaven. When they say somebody married, your first husband and your first wife is the only one until death separates you apart. The narrow way. Among preachers, you know, so many things are going. That's why I have cited 1, 2, 3 holy men of God. My number one is Adeboye. My number two is Bileakone. My number three is Kumuyi. I told myself, it is the heaven these people want to go that I want to go. And it is the way they are living their lives that I want to follow. Because Because the broad style, the broad way is there. Something wants me. The way many people are going for this thing is wrong. So, let me follow these babas. I don't like a man of God or a man that does not fear God. You know the world, because we're in the world, sometimes we are opportune to be high up there. We know what happens. Our fathers, when they come around God, they fear, they tremble, they quake. They don't just come around God and be jarring. I'll say, yeah. You know, when I see somebody doing like that, I'll just tell you that. I'll tell myself, they didn't send you to me. Oh, run and see me. I like somebody. You know, the one said, be still and know that I am God. You can't be invited to meet for the first time. And even many other times, the president of America, and you just bounce. And you're just, okay. This is not club. This is White House, please. This is White House. There's a minimum sense of decorum you're supposed to comport yourself by. Don't just be bouncing around like this. See, what, you know, Jesus says some serious, very, very serious, actually dangerous things. John chapter 10. Give me from verse 1. If you listen to Jesus, the man that has written God's exam and had passed, had A's in all courses, fruit of the Spirit, A's in all of them, gift of the Spirit, A's in all of them, communication, interpersonal communication, A's in all of it. Everything God can mark a man on, Jesus got A. Follow me as we read. Verily, verily, Jesus now speaking, I say unto you, and when Jesus starts with verily, verily, it's a serious matter he wants to, you know, say unto us. I say unto you that he that does not enter into heaven by the door, and that door is the narrow one, into the shepherd fold, but climbeth up some other way. Who is such a fellow? The same is a thief and a robber. Verse 2, quickly. But he that entereth in by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. Next. To him the porter openeth, and the sheep hear his voice, and he calleth his own sheep by name, and leadeth them out. Next. And when he putteth forth his own sheep, he goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. Next. And a stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him. For they know not the voice of the strangers. This parable Jesus spake unto them, but they understood not what things they were which he spake unto them. Then said Jesus unto them again, verily, verily, or truly, truly, sincerely, sincerely, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. This is my trouble. All that ever came before me, what are they? And what? Sir, come for me. Come and represent a father. Who should I pick? Mommy, come and represent a mom. Great lady, come and represent a daughter. Where are you? Please step forward for me. Come and represent your son. My girl, this way. Mommy, this way. You guys move this way. Which one of you? This is dad. This is a family dad, a family mom. And these are the kids, children. Give me the scripture back, verse 8 now, please, quick. Here, are you hearing? Am I in the right place? All all liars go to hell. When Jesus said all, he meant all. All that ever came before me. First of all, you guys, all that ever came into your life, into your reckoning, to present a model of living, and that normally starts from parental influence, parental upbringing. All that ever came into your life ahead of me, whether it is daddy or mommy or lecturers, friends, uncles, aunties, relations, neighbors, sometimes, unfortunately, pastors that came to bring an influence, an orientation of living into your lives ahead of me, Jesus. Daddy, mommy, pastor, friends, auntie, brother, uncle, whoever, they are thieves and they are robbers. Only they are thieves. Olosha, robbers. If your parents didn't give you a Christian, a Jesus, a godly upbringing, daddy is a thief, a robber, mommy is a thief and a robber. The first boyfriend you had that deflowered you, what's the name? Ole. A thief and a robber. Your first girlfriend, even if you didn't do anything, that girl, what name did Jesus give the fellow? Thief and robber. Every philosophy of living that entered your heart to give you an orientation of behavior, that philosophy is a thief and a robber. Oh! So your first best friend, first female best friend, female, you like yourself, you go together, sometimes you go to eat together, to watch film, to do whatever, your first female best friend, who gave you, is who contributed a living style or a style of living to your life, that friend, innocent as she may be, is a thief and a robber. The first form of education you had, if it was not a Christian education, education, science as it is, innocence as it is, your schooling, if it was the first kind of information that entered you, that schooling is a thief and a robber. Everything that entered your life ahead of me, you took after your dad in behavior. Your dad is a thief and a robber. You took after your mom, as a mother. You just liked your mom's style, you just took after her. You gravitated towards her lifestyle and whatever. Mom. Your mom. Beloved mom. Precious mom. Jesus marked her and scored her as a thief and a robber. She came into your life.
Christ Jesus is the Lord and King. Christ Jesus is the Lord and King. Everybody sing. Everybody sing. Christ Jesus is the Lord and King. Everybody sing. Everybody sing.
Say it.
Christ, for Christ Jesus.
Thank you very much for taking time to listen to this message. I want to believe that you are really blessed. Peradventure, you just joined us when the message had already started. I want to encourage you to join us again on Saturday, and we will continue where we stopped this week, next week, same time.
Careful what you think about. Most of the time, that is what you're gonna.
And if you
about,
choose to worship with us, we are located at 15227 Old Richmond Road, Sugarland, Texas, 77498. You will be glad you came. God bless you.
We don't smoke, we don't drink, we don't cheat and lie. We never alone. The Spirit lives inside. The Spirit's holy. By His grace, so are we. And He protects us all day, even in our sleep. So we invite you, come and roll the way we roll. On fire.
but no need for the water hose. Are you in danger? Christ can overcome those obstacles. If you're lacking, he can provide you a pocket full.
Living holy, you know we are righteous.